he'll make slaves of you. Resist while you can.
This is the NPC dialogue of the new Sunspire Trial in Elsewhere. I hope you enjoy it. I actually think it's really funny. Thanks.
More faithful answer the roar of the first cat. Come, come, welcome. Alkosh's booming voice reaches farther with every passing day, bringing new pilgrims for me to greet. Come, bring your offerings and kneel before the great cat returned. Yes, Walker. Divine Alkosh has returned to this perch to call the Khajiit who have strayed back to him. Though any who hear his word and obey are welcome here. Who is Alkosh? Gek! Little Tar has kicked sand over the first cat so long that his name is forgotten. Alkosh is the first divine, the dragon king of cats. Khajiit have strayed from him, but his return to right our path. Come, see for yourself. He has called his faithful to his temple, and you have answered. Once you lay your eyes upon divinity, everything will become clear. This way, come, join in our worship and praise Alkosh's return. This is his temple, Walker. But not just any temple. It is built upon holy ground. It was on this summit that Alkosh stood and defended us from the White Snake Pelinal. There would be no Khajiit left if not for his divine intervention. Indeed, Walker. Indeed. Long ago, the White Snake terrorized the lands to the north. His hatred of elves knew no end, and they were so hungry for their blood that he saw elves where there were only Khajiit. Khajiit were nearly wiped out by his blind rage. The White Snake stained the savannas in our blood. But Khajiit are natural climbers. They scaled this peak to escape the madman. But what he lacked in grace, he overcame with ferocity. Pelinal wrestled with the mountain until he, too, stood above it. Hearing Khajiit's prayers, Alkosh descended from the heavens like a shooting star. His battle cry split the sky as he cast the crusader out of elsewhere, and the wound remains as a reminder of the debt we owe. Too few remember that since Riddlethar. He is the first cat, winged and glorious, radiant as the sun and eternal. It is only fitting Khajiit follow in his footsteps. Khajiit are close cousins to dragons, you know. Can you not see the resemblance? All the races are children of Nirni, but when Azura made Khajiit Khajiit, she made us in the image of perfection. Alkosh was swift and graceful, but also great and powerful, and clever, and wise. What else could be all these things but a cat? Are we not sleek as the dragon? Do we not have claws sharp as the dragon? Are our eyes not like those of the dragon? Azura was wise to conceal our true nature under silky fur, but we are as near to dragons as cats can be. Alkosh is a protector, Walker. Though many have shamefully forgotten him, he ensures the steady movement of the moons. Without him, Joan and Jode would be locked in place, and terrible things would slip through the lunar lattice. If my words were enough for the faithful, then this temple would have overflowed with worshippers long ago. You may doubt my mortal tongue, Walker, but one cannot deny divinity when one sees it. Lay your eyes upon Alkosh, and all will be made clear. Too many Khajiit have been weaned on tales of Riddlethar, and Too many years have passed since Alkash first graced us with his presence. I feared I would leave behind an empty temple. But Alkash heard my prayers and came to guide his wayward king. To inspire faith, to restore his temple to glory. Alkash will put an end to Khajiit's suffering and lead his people to stand united and strong again.